Hello and welcome to Around the House with Kay and Tom. And today I just want to show you a little bit about this Ninja Foodi. Somebody asked me the other day about how you cleaned it. And I wanted to know if I'd make a video on it. I said, well, it'd have to be probably short because there's not a whole lot to cleaning this thing. That's one of the easiest cooking appliances you'll ever see to clean. So anyway, I'll get started with it. And right here, the pressure lid. Now, after you use that, now some people take this off right here, this little, that's where your valve turns that. That's where this turns that right here. And some people like to take that off and look down there and clean. Now, every time I've took it off, there's nothing been in it at all, nothing to even remotely think about cleaning. But anyway, some people like to just pull that off and you have to apply quite a bit of pressure to it and it'll come off. But then the main thing is you want to get this seal out right here. Because if this seal was not, can't get my throat clear, if this seal's not right, this lid will not seal up on this pressure cooker. And you can let it sit there all day long, it's just not going to work. So the best thing really to do is go ahead and order your spare. They're pretty cheap, so you can get them about anywhere, I think, Amazon. You know, places like that. So anyway, let me put this. I will put both of these in the sink. When you get ready to clean the crisper basket, you take and put your thumb on each one of these, on two of these little prongs here, and you just push down gently and it'll come right off just like that. And you take your crisper basket, put it down in the water, just rinse it around. It's not going to take much to clean this. It's about like the pot. Like that. One little spot. That wasn't nothing there, it was just laying there. Over I hadn't rinsed it good. Still got a spot there. Now as you see down there, that's just clean as a whistle. Set that aside for a minute and then take this little thing here. You want to make sure you clean this because if you don't take this off and clean it, you'll have stuff build up on these things here and that's not good. So, but it's real easy to clean just like this. I heard one person complain about cleaning this and I never did figure out why, because it's always been real easy for me. Well, it's because I do it every time. If you don't do it every time, it might be a different story. And now that's all this for cleaning the crisper basket. And let me get my dish towel here and I'll show you how to put the easy way to put it back together. Set that down like just like that. And dry off this basket just a little bit. Just like that. And then you just center this over the top of it and just push down like that and you'll hear it click and it's back on there. And now you're ready to go again. Okay, now I've got that stuff washed up, and now here's this pot, and as you can see, I just finished using it. I'm going to set it over here for a second, and I'm going to move the camera over here so I can show you just how easy this is to clean up. And you see now, I've been searing stuff down in there and all this stuff, so hold on a minute, let me get moved around here. But before I move this cooker, I want to show you one more thing on the back. You have this little tray right here. That just pulls out like that. Now this is about the most I've ever seen. It's just a little trashy looking stuff. I've never seen much more of anything in there than that. I guess if you overfilled it or something, you might be able to see more than that in it. But that's about all I've ever seen. Now let me get things moved around. I'm going to wash this out and put it back in too. Anything in this pot, it's just like it was last time you saw it. Now we'll put it down this dishwater here. Swish it around a little bit. take my rag. One more little spot. Now I do have a couple of little nicks down in the bottom of this pan. I don't know how I got there, but I imagine being I'm the only one to use it, I did it, so hey. But there you see, if I get out to rinse it out a little bit, get over here to where I can rinse it. So there you see, you know, that's out, and if you watch a couple of my videos, you can see how I leave stuff down the bottom of it and sear and saute it and stuff. And it's never been any harder than that right there to clean. And I don't put anything in it to start with, like any sprays or anything like that. I don't put anything in it that you don't see me put in it. And that's about it right there, how hard it is. So, I'm gonna move along. Okay, everything is washed and cleaned up, and I want to show you how you put this back down in here. There's no particular place it goes that I know of, but you just put it down there on the edge like that and just start pushing it around. Make sure you put it down real good all the way around. Just like that. Now that's back down in there. Now that's all it is to that pressure cleaner. That's all it is to the pressure cooker lid right there. Just do that. Now you're set to go again. As soon as you get it dried off, put it up. Now, it's just like it was to start with. And now, make sure you don't forget to put your little tray in the back here. Like I say, I've never seen much of anything in it, but it just sits back in there just like that. Okay, and I'll turn it around. Raise the lid. Put the pot back in it, 6-quart pot. And here's the crisper basket that sits right down in it. I imagine this is how I got a couple of chips in my bottom there. I'll drop it down in there sometimes once. When it's getting a little hot, I'll drop it down there by accident. So, that's about it. There's not much to cleaning up this Ninja Foodie. Like I say, it's one of the easiest kitchen appliances I've ever seen to clean. And so, if you can, give me a thumbs up and join my channel. I sure appreciate it. And thank you very much for watching my video. And, hey, if you want one of these, I've got a link to it down below. You can check into it and see if you'd like it. So, till next time, y'all have a real good, safe day. And come back and see me real soon. And thanks again for watching. Goodbye.